Go ahead, instructor.
Go to advanced and intermediate level students, students training at home. Welcome everybody. Let us do our breathing. Take a selfish moment here. I've had an extremely compressed and hectic day, so I'm not going to talk during the breathing. I'm just going to breathe for a couple minutes. And I invite you to breathe too. Okay, shake it out and let's go ahead and run the first section. Set up. Warm up mindset.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Shake it up and get your saber. Together through the turnaround of the hidden knife after the slice up left and or up and down, and then I'm probably gonna just ask to see it so to see if there's anything that we need to help with before moving on.
Yes, ma'am.
And begin. Step up, seven stars left. Step up, seven stars right. Step back, white train spreads wings. Turn around, hidden knife. White crane stands on one leg. Diagonal push knife. Lift knife left. Lift knife right. Straightforward push knife. Fair lady, work shuttles. Center lift. Middle pull. Horizontal push knife. forward push knuckle. Turn around over the head, hidden neck. Slice up. Slice down right. Straight forward push knuckle. Turn around over the head, hidden neck. And reset.
Yeah.
Okay, let me see it, please. And if you're training from home, just do your best. I'm going to call the names out so you're not totally in the woods. If it's awkward, just do the parts that you can. It's okay. Alrighty. Step up 7 stars left. Step up 7 stars right. Step back, white crane, spreads wings. Turn around, hidden knife. White crane stands on one leg. Diagonal push knife. Lift knife left. Lift knife right. Straight forward push knife. Fair ladies, work shuttles. Center lift. Middle pull. Horizontal push knife. Straight forward push knife. Turn around over the head, hidden knife. Slice up left. Slice down right. And, oh yeah, turn around, straight forward push knife, sorry. We're done, no, we're not. Turn around over the head, hidden knife. Very good. Okay, release. Any questions or anything that you'd like some guidance on or help with? Any of anything up to that point?
I think I got it.
Yeah. One thing to watch for is transitioning into starting the transition to straightforward push knife. Resist the urge to bring it up. It comes up from the top.
Mm.
Yeah, so hope you still at home. What I mean is sometimes it kind of ends up just, I don't know if I can do it. It scoops up somehow. I honestly can't, I know it if I see it, but.
So
it
like that, I'm going diagonally, I guess.
So what you're going to do is, let's see, the pickup is over here. So I'm going to follow through, and if I follow through, I'm going to let this kind of relax out.
Mm-hmm.
And then instead of coming up, I'm going to let it cut up in a circle. Yes. Yeah. So for at home, we talked a little bit about this in Master's Pack yesterday. It's follow through. I'm exaggerating, but I'm relaxing. I follow through, which says that way. And then I step back, which turns us over and brings it over the top. Does that make sense? And then it can make that full circle to here. So that was one thing. And the other one was the second one. It looked good, but watch to not end up in double dragons after the slice down left. So I'm here. It's and then it's here. On the second time, it looked more correct. The first time,
yeah.
I looked over my shoulder, and it was a little double dragon-y. So just
we
remember,
spent a lot of time on that, but it's such a challenge for me is getting my feet in the right place on that move.
Yeah, I get it. I mean, it's so. Let's see what helped me. I kind of thought of that advancing like part of the wild horse's mane,
mm-hmm.
even though my arms are doing something completely different. It's that I'm moving forward, but I'm doing things at angles.
Right.
So I kind of like, oh, it's part of my horse's mane, except not, but going now.
Yeah.
With a thing in my hand.
Well, head instructor Fig said, you know, imagine your opponent more out here.
Yes.
So I'm just stepping too forward.
Too forward. Yeah, it really is. I mean, it's going to feel weird, but then when you get it, it'll feel really
mm-hmm.
good. Because if I step too far forward, I'm using my arm to make that snap. Whereas if I step mostly sideways, I close my hip. And then same thing here, I'm not cutting diagonally, I'm rocking and stepping in my hip. So it'll feel easier, and I know this is not easy, but you will feel less strain and muscle, like need of muscle control in the upper body if you get the foot placement right. So just check in with your body when you do it. Like, did I feel like I used my arms? What might make me use my arms less? And see if the stepping helps with that. So let's do just that a couple times to practice paying attention to our footwork. So we will start, we'll basically go from the end of turnaround of the head hidden knife through the end of the next turnaround of the head hidden knife. So we will be here. And slice up left. Slice down right. Reset. Oh, I didn't follow my instructions. This time we're going to go all the way through. And slice up left, slice down right, straight forward push knife, nice big swing, turn around over the head, hidden knife. Reset. Nice and slow so you can give your body a chance to feel any changes you'd like to make. Slice up. Left. Slice down, right. Straight forward, push left. Turn around, over the head, hidden knife. One more time. Forward push line. Turn around over the head. Hidden knife. And release. Questions? Comments? Opinions? Theory?
I could feel the waist difference.
Mm-hmm.
Closing it with the waist rather than the arms.
Good. If you didn't hear her, she said she's able to feel the closing with the waist. It's very easy in this form to slip into making your arms do it without, I mean, you don't even, without thinking, without feeling, without noticing, you're like, oh, I've stepped, and now, but my waist didn't have anything to do with that. So I know this form feels fun to speed it up, but the slower you can do it when you're trying to get quality in your moves, that's where you can start to feel those subtle shifts. If we speed it up, we tend to go on autopilot. And then it's very easy for your timing to get off. What I mean by that is, I'm in my zone, I'm doing the thing, I've already stepped and shifted, but I haven't, so then my arm has to do it. And then I've stepped and shifted, but my arm has to do it. Versus, you know, I'm listening with my body. You know, so, and if you speed it up too much, you don't have a chance to feel that all the time. So, switch up your training pace, whether you're at home or here or wherever. Play with your speed a little bit. You know, speed helps with sequence, but some of these finer adjustments, like 10 important points check-ins, are best if you're a little bit slower. Okay, let me see it again. Let's go from the top. And we'll probably start doing our lessons. Alright. Step up seven stars left. Step up seven stars right. Step back white crane spreads wings. Turn around, hidden knife. Better waist in this one. Good. White crane stands on one leg. Diagonal push knife. Lift knife left. Lift knife right. Straight forward, push knife. Excellent, Miss Remington, you got it. Fair lady, work shoulders. Relax your shoulders, Miss Burlington. There you go. Center lift. Middle pull. Horizontal push knife. around, over the head, hidden knife. Slice up, left. Slice down, right. And release. Stop there. Excellent. How'd it feel?
Better.
Smoother.
Smoother, better. Good. Good, good, good. Okay, everyone here, you've seen, this is not your first saber rotation.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, so we can hopefully work off, yes, but good. That's good. I like seeing 5, 4. So the next moves are the slice up, slice down. My goal is to try to not make it look waddly or cheerleadery. Try to make it look stealthy. And then obviously there's the two white crane slash double jump front kick. But let's take a look at, let's do it together so we see where we are. From the end of turn right over the head, hidden knife. Right now I'm just kind of looking for the quality of the slices. And slice up, slice down. Slice up, slice down. I'm just doing some slices. Slice. But it's not just turning side to side. There's a forward kind of thrusting to it. Yeah. So imagine, you know, it doesn't have to be a person. It could be an idea, a thought, a plant, a piece of tofu. But you know, you're thrusting into something, and then you're striking into something. So there's some intention to it that will change the way it feels. It won't feel quite so silly, because this can feel like, what am I doing? Well, so let's do that a couple times together, thinking of, yep, very good, Mr. Flynn. Thinking of that slight spiral forward. This would feel weird. That would be too much. This would, so same sensation to center lift. You know, you've got that spiral, and it just, you know, this feels weird, but if you stay connected, it rotates 3/4, maybe?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How's it feel? Good?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's break the double jump front kick down into its components, and I'm getting a little bit prepared because I've got super arthritic knees today, so jumping is not my forte today, but I don't want to rob you guys of the experience, so let's give it a try. So we start from our turnout over the head, hidden knife, and this time we'll do the correct number, so slice up, slice down, slice up, and put it away, and then yep, and then yep. Okay. Yeah, very good. with this. Try not to lose, not that either one of you are losing, I'm also kind of teaching to the camera. When you speed it up and smooth it out into the double jump front kick, try to keep those components of, so you get that you get the lift and the flow of both those knees. Sometimes it can kind of speed up and it gets muddied through a little bit. That's not what I saw, but I just, it can happen. So imagine that second golden rooster is in there, even though it's implied. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, let's do it. And front up, down, up, and knee. You guys can break it down on your own. I'm gonna talk to the camera. If the jump is difficult, so you guys just go on with your legal selves. If the jump is too difficult, you can easily and smoothly do a walkthrough version of this. So I will demonstrate that while they practice their jumps. So I've done my slice. So I'm here. Golden rooster. Step, kick, step, step. Same number of steps, basically, without the jump. If your knees are delicate, if you're feeling insecure about it, it can look just as smooth. Smoothness being the key. So again, rooster, then step, this hand sort of counterbalances as a kick, hit, step, step. I encourage you to practice it both ways. This isn't a huge jump. You're certainly not trying to clear a lot of ground. It's sort of like a little popcorn kernel. Boop, it's up, not distance. So, don't stress about the height or the distance, but think of a lift. Should feel very buoyant. Very good, Mr. Schwinn. But if you can't do that, you can make it look equally smooth while walking through it. A couple more passes. Set it away. Knee. Step. Any questions? Having gone through the jump a few times.
Can you provide some feedback?
Absolutely. Okay. Please.
So you mentioned like the cheerleader thing.
Uh-huh.
I think I do that.
I don't know.
It's really fun to kick high.
It is super fun. kicking high does not mean cheerleader. Cheerleader
okay.
is a special kind of thing. I'll show you cheerleader.
I like doing that too.
That's not cheerleader.
Okay.
Don't focus so much on making this a completely straight leg kick. Let bring that knee up and then snap out.
Knee up. Okay.
Yeah. Give it a try. Yeah. Well, bend
sort
over.
Of.
No, it's okay. So that's where that second golden rooster is.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Because you're from here. Here and then knee, think of almost like you're going to start a third one. Knee up and then knee up to kick.
How do you do it from here?
Let me see. My words are not. Just drive that knee up on that kick. So let it.
So this comes
so
down.
So put that down and then drive with your knee. Yep. And
wait, no.
You're gonna have to because those are two different things. So
yeah.
You need to do it quickly.
Okay.
But when you're kind of leaning with a straight leg,
okay.
lean with the knee, and then let the other
kick out.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Basically, jump with your knee.
Uh-huh.
Instead of trying to do the kick, I found it easier just to come up, do the step.
Yeah, she's got her process. Give it a try.
It's an amazing high kick.
It is, yeah.
I'm gonna have to
forget what I said and just do it.
Okay.
And then we'll see. I hope at home you're practicing. That was exactly it.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yes. I'm gonna have to work that into my muscle memory.
Yeah, I think of skipping. You skip.
Okay.
Kind of skipping into it. It's like.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So yeah. You've got it. And it's like, I don't got it. But the only feedback that I would have is not be so stiff on that kick. So you drive with the leg and then let the snap come afterwards.
Yes, ma'am.
But other than that, looks excellent. Any other questions? I know. Anybody need to take a mask defogging break? No? All right. Let's string a couple pieces together. So let's go from the end of turnaround of the head and knife through the slices, and then into that sequence to the hit camp punch. If this feels like a barrage of moves, don't sweat it. You will get it. Remember, in beginner daytime day class master's path, I'm breaking down bits of the same. We're not moving in sequence. We're just taking little bits and just working for quality. So that's another resource to you. If it's too many moves, I don't. There's other places to learn little bits, so do not panic. All right, so here we go. So we've done our turnaround overhead hidden knife. We are going to do slice up, left. Slice down, right. Strike forward, push knife. Turn around, over the head, hidden knife. Slice up, slice down, slice up, put it away, golden rooster, kick, there you go, hidden hand punch. Again?
Yes, ma'am.
Slice up, left, slice down, right. Straight forward, push back. Turn around, over the head, hidden knife. Slice up, slice down. Slice up, turn away, rooster. I was getting, my rooster's confused, that's why I was even getting confused.
Okay.
I was putting third section roosters with a saber in my hand and have a rifle.
Okay.
So, first one, this is the driving move. This one, which then brings this one up.
Okay.
So, and that only works if you're moving through it quickly.
Uh-huh.
Because if you're not, it's super hard. Because you're basically doing a double jump front kick from static, which is very difficult. I've never been an airborne person. Like in gymnastics, I was a floor and low beam person, so I'm not an acrobat, never have been. But basically that is here.
Ah.
So it's different if you're breaking it down. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's gonna feel a little bit different doing it slow versus quickly. But if you think of pistoning your knees,
mm-hmm.
regardless of if you're doing it from a standstill, from a walk, or smoothing it through, think of your knees as pistons. It will help. But the height is great. That's great. Any questions? No? Want to try it from the top?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure.
And And when I touch them, they go, you know, kind of a walk-through, slowish pace. Try not to get ahead of me, to give yourself a chance to integrate any changes you'd like to make. And again, think about staying relaxed so that you can feel that expanding and contracting, that opening and closing. Step up, seven stars left. Step up, seven stars right. Step back, slight frame, spread the wings. Turn around, hidden knife. White crane stands on one leg. Diagonal, push knife. Lift knife, left. Good, lift knife, right. Straight forward, push knife. Fair lady, work shuttles. Center lift. Middle pull. Horizontal push knife. Straight forward push knife. You got it, Ms. Williams, and that's it. Turn around, over the head, hidden knife. Slice up, left. Slice down, right. Straight forward, push knife. Turn around, over the head, hidden knife. Here we are, slice up, slice down. Slice up, give it away. Knee, hip, hand punch. Excellent. Any questions? Anything you'd like to see? No? More practice? few breaths of non-filtered?
Yeah.
Today was one of those days I went through three of these with my massage.
Yeah.
Get it off my face. Yeah. Grateful for them, but then you get difficult, particularly if you've been talking and reading in this for a while. All right, we have about three more minutes. Let's do it one more time from the top.
Yes, ma'am.
And this time, same pace, but no names. Just try to feel, not think, and try to stay together. Begin. One other helpful tip about those kicks. The saber will help you. So this movement helps get that knee up. So I'm here, or is that right? That funny? So it isn't just the knee, this is fluid as well. So by bending that arm, that helps bring that knee up, which helps get you the height to then kick with that leg. See if that works with a walkthrough. Pretty sure it does. Yes. It also makes it look cleaner and more smooth together if you're not jumping, by making sure this doesn't kind of, it looks weird. Somebody watching it might not know why it looks strange, but this stops, and in Tai Chi, stuff doesn't stop. The body continues to move, so it'll help you even in the walkthrough. Woo! It just makes it, you feel balanced. So don't forget about this. Don't let it be a dead arm. Let it move fluidly with you. So any last questions or comments? Good work coming right along. Send me questions or feedback or help, SOS, an email flare, and we'll answer any questions you have. But let's go ahead and bow out our life skill.
Okay, Head Instructor, can you remind me what you said about, you said something that really, about the hands.
Ah, yes.
I forget what it was.
What it was. So, tiger, it's grabbing. So, as I face the camera, this. Here, out,
bend,
and back.
Okay.
So, yes, sometimes I see sort of these club paws kind of going out. So it's out and grabbing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Yep. Path of self-mastery
requires a courageous heart.
A courageous heart shows strength in the face of fear.
Path of self-mastery requires a courageous heart. A courageous heart shows strength
in the face of fear.
Path of self-mastery requires a courageous heart. A
courageous heart shows strength in the face of fear. Yeah, traditionally it's a pet grab, mm-hmm. which is brutal. It just really hurts. You can try it on yourself sometimes. Get in this deltoid and peck and pull on it.
Yeah.
It's effective.
Okay.
Yeah. It's really about peeling the whole chest wall off the,
ugh.
Yeah, it's gross. That's me as the anatomy person, like, well, here's what it's doing. It's super gross and painful. But yeah, that would, our pecs are our primary strength drivers. So if you've got if you sustained an injury like that, your whole upper body is not working properly. You've lost a tremendous amount of movability, really. I mean, it will stop everything. So, tiger. Alrighty, let's bow out.
Bow to Head Instructor.
Bow to intermediate and advanced students. I got that backwards. And relax, that's ready to dismiss.